So my dear friends, this is behind me. What you see behind me is this huge cave. It is the place from which once, back in the antiquity, the mighty river called Banias, today Banias or Hermon, began. And then due to the tectonic activities, to the earthquakes, it changed its place from which it emerges today. Right here in front of me, you see this beautiful spring, one of the headwaters of the Jordan River. This place is called Banias today, but the ancient name of this place is Panias, the place of worship to the god of nature, whose name was Pan, half man, half goat, a god that was responsible for all the possible sexual perversions, god of love, god of war, because he created panic in the midst of the enemies. And this place was also in the beginning of a common era called Caesarea Philippi. And we read in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 16, that Jesus comes here in the realms of the Caesarea Philippi with his disciples. And that's where he's asking them this important question: who do you think the Son of Man is? Who do you think the Son of Man is? And they come up with so many answers. People think that Jesus is Jeremiah. People think that Jesus is a risen up from the dead John the Baptist. People think that Jesus is Elijah, because people were expecting Elijah to come. And that's what the people around Jesus think that who he is. The disciples were also asked the same question, and Peter comes up with the answer: you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And Jesus encourages him, and he says, this faith, this revelation that I am in the Messiah, that I am a Son of the living God, will be like a rock, and on this rock I am going to build my church. And the gates of Hades, because this area was believed to be the place that connected underworld to this world, from which God Pan would transfer into the underworld. And that's way maybe why Jesus comes here with the disciples, in order to confront this pagan place of worship, this hell in the eyes of the Jewish believers. That's why probably he was here. Today it's a beautiful area where the spring was turned into the national park, and thousands, even I would say millions of Christians come here annually to see and to take a look at this place. Welcome to Israel.